All right, guys. Today I want to take a look at the flipped classroom. So like I said in the intro video, we're talking about this concept of a flipped classroom. So what exactly is a flipped classroom? I found this great graphic, again, from one of my favorite websites, which is Edudemic. And I've talked about that one before, and like I said, I would continue to reference that website and use it as a classroom teacher. So this graphic from their website has a really good overview of what is a flipped classroom. So their definition of a flipped classroom is, the flipped classroom inverts the traditional teaching methods, delivering instruction online, outside of class, and moving homework into the classroom. So this graphic shows the traditional classroom is, this is a teaching term that we often see, sage on a stage, thinking of the teacher as some wizard who wows the audience with this knowledge and feeds it into them. We know that that's not necessarily the best teaching method anymore, and that the traditional lecture model doesn't always fit, though it is still a viable option as far as a teaching method. The flipped classroom then, in essence, takes the teacher role and sets it on the side and thinks of them more as a mentor who walks alongside the students rather than simply talking to them. So you have, rather than talking to the audience, you have the audience engaging in stuff at home, which would be the students, and then when they come to class, the activity is the teacher walking alongside these students as they work through the given project or the homework that day. And as you can see then, the homework is, watching the lecture when you get home tonight. So what a classroom model does, students watch a lecture at home, and it doesn't even necessarily need to be a lecture like what you're hearing now. It could be watching a YouTube video like this one. It could be watching infos like this. It could be reading blogs or reading professional articles, a teacher's guide to the flipped classroom, or it could be a traditional lecture with you actually watching me. The nice thing about the flipped classroom is that it allows students who can move ahead quickly in work, they can take it at their own pace. So little Johnny, who's always bored in class because he understands what's going on, he can blow through these videos and move on to the next part. Whereas little Sally, who often finds class to be far too fast-paced, can backtrack in a video. If she doesn't understand what it is, she can take the video and watch it again, as opposed to hearing it once and as the teacher moves on in a traditional lecture in class. The concept then is to engage the classroom and help them and walk alongside them as they work through the work. So the theoretical framework then is technology and activity are the two key components of a flipped classroom model. So in essence, the students need to have access to some sort of technology in order to be able to engage in the use of the flipped classroom model. And then learning takes place through activities, given activities in class that the teacher comes up with. That could be group work, that could be other such working through homework. So where does this all come from? How does this play out? Well, like I said, flipped classrooms is not necessarily a new concept. Take a look. In 2007, so we're talking near 7 years ago, the concept of flipped classroom came about. And in fact, I found articles that mentioned it as far back as 2006. So this teacher discovered software to record PowerPoint presentations. The software that I'm currently using is QuickTime, and it has a screen recorder and it has a video recorder. I'm just simply recording what you see on my desktop right now. So what he did is he recorded and posted live lectures for students who missed class. The online lecture started to spread, and so he was asked by teachers to speak about his idea of putting content online for students who had missed class. Teachers began using these online videos and moved it to what we now call podcasts. What I would call in the current world would then be things as up-to-date as what we looked at last week, vlogs or blogs. So what's driving this change in education? Well, there's two factors that are driving the increased adoption of the flipped classroom. The first is poor learning outcomes. Excuse me. The traditional one-size-fits-all model often results in limited concept engagement. For instance, the way that you and I were probably traditionally taught, sit in class, listen. It's leading to high dropout rates. It's leading to less engagement. Students we're seeing are no longer able to do college-type skills. And more importantly, as students leave college, we're seeing that they are less and less prepared for the workforce. The other thing is the prevalence of online videos. Take, for instance, the percentage of internet users, and think again of the daily content that is put onto YouTube, as I've so often shown you. One good example is the video series that I showed you, Khan Academy. They upload videos all the time, and that's just one of the plethora that are out there now that are engaging in this flipped classroom model. So what it looks like? Many schools and classrooms have adopted this flipped classroom model. Here they walk you through more examples of what a flipped classroom looks like. Though, again, this is just one example that they come up with. A simple search on YouTube will bring up many, 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 many examples of what a flipped classroom looks like. Take, for instance, this is one example from a teacher that I found, Katie Gimbar's flipped classroom, in which she here is answering the questions about, okay, the flipped classroom model is great, but what do I do when students don't watch the videos? Well, it's the same kind of questions that people are asking about what do you do when kids aren't participating in class. So she addresses some of those videos through several of her playlists that she has that are very useful. So the results. Here, according to this, to Edudemic and the studies that had done this, I believe taken from the Ohio State University and a flipped classroom conference, they found that in a class before the flip, 50% of freshmen failed English and 44% of freshmen failed math. After the flipped classroom model had been implemented, they found that 19% of freshmen failed English and only 13% of freshmen failed math. Here you see there are 736 discipline cases in one semester. After the flip, you had 249 discipline cases within the classroom. So this single study is showing that the level of involvement and engagement in a flipped classroom is significantly higher than in a traditional model. So my question that I want to leave with you is this. Before the flip, after the flip. Is this a viable option in your classroom? If so, in what grade? If so, in what class? Or is this just another one of those teaching fads that is coming and going, as we've seen with so many other things? I'm curious to see what your thoughts on these questions are, and I hope that we can discuss them in class when we meet about them after you've watched this video, like the great students that you are. Thanks for watching and listening, guys, and we'll see you in class.